time, I didn't even have enough money to buy a business. I just been in this country for 3 years, but she gave me that opportunity.
Maria Elizabeth Flores Baez has a lot to be thankful for. At 24 years old, she emigrated to the United States in 2001 after her father passed away. She learned English and worked as a housekeeper to make ends meet. With the support of her former employer, she achieved the American dream a few years later when she became owner of La Bombonera Merilu in Astoria. It means favors in Greek, Italian, and French, and is also named after her eldest child.
And she told me, if you are really interested, I'm going to try to help you. I'm going to be with you. And let's go. Let's do it.
Now a wife and mom of three, her party supply store is still going strong 17 years later and has become a staple in the neighborhood. But she has faced some challenges along the way.
With the pandemic, as everybody knows, we have to close the business. Taking care of my husband, who was really sick of COVID, during my free time that I have after the 3 kids.
And most recently, Ida. The storm hit just as she was beginning to recover from a lag in sales caused by the pandemic.
The door is all damaged up to here. We can't believe it how this water can move the air conditioner and the fridge all the way close to the stairs.
Now, stormwater came gushing down through these pipes just behind the column you see there. Now, the water quickly filled the basement to about 2 feet. The saving grace, this little doorway allowed the water to receive a lot more quickly, minimizing the damage. She lost between $8,000 and $10,000 in goods and equipment and is also dealing with mold as a result of floodwaters. But with the help of the Queens Chamber of Commerce and its Small Business Resource Network, Maria Elizabeth is able to pick up the pieces.
She was obviously very nervous, very concerned, and I'm very glad that I was able to help her business with the grant money. She was able to pay all of her rent. We also got her in connection with an in-house tech specialist who was able to create a website for her, which is very important now in this COVID era.
There's still a lot of cleanup ahead, but Maria Elizabeth says she's fortunate to have made it through the storm and looks forward to brighter days. She shares this advice to those facing similar circumstances.
Always look for help. Don't say that you can't, because you can.
In Astoria, Queens, I'm Stacey Ann Gooden, Pix 11 News.